Do you want to play the music?
Yeah, just be quiet for a second. Hold on. As soon as the intro is over, you can talk. Hold on. Here we go. I'm starting it now.
You're listening to Off Limits. Liberal, irreverent, oh, and really, really gay.
Hello, everybody. Thanks for joining me on the show tonight. Welcome to Off Limits. We are playing music, apparently. Hold on. Forgot to pause that. There we go. Welcome to the show. Thanks for joining me tonight. We are joined tonight by Desert Rose and Prankville, USA. Are you guys there?
Yes. Yes, we are here.
Yeah, I'm here.
Let's see if we can hear you on the playback. Let's see, just to make sure. We're trying something new tonight, so let's see if this works.
All right.
Oh, yes. Excellent. It's working beautifully. Wonderful. Fuck yeah. All right. So
wonderful.
Thanks for joining me tonight. If you want to check me out, you can go to offlimitshow.com. You can listen to the show there live. You can also go to iTunes and listen to the show there if you have an iTunes-capable player. You can also listen to the show on Spreaker.com. And if you're in the chat room on Spreaker.com, you can chat with me there as well as people talking on the show. So we were just talking to – I was just talking to Todd and to Desert about what the fuck were we just talking about? Forgot
everything.
We were talking about something. I forgot what we were talking about. Oh my god. Well, I just want to tell you guys something that happened today, though, and you can tell me what you think. Okay, so I have a client, and today I went to three of my clients' houses, and what I did is I'd have a photographer take pictures of all their places at once, because they pay for a day rate for taking them all pictures of the projects I've done. Anyway, so I went to three of them today. The last one I went to my client's place, and my client was talking to me the whole time while the photographer's doing his business, whatever, yada, 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 yada. And, you know, talking about himself and this and that, whatever. Okay, fine. That's cool. But every time I would say anything or interject anything into the conversation, like, well, you know, with me, blah, 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 he'd go, oh, that's nice. So anyway, back to me, you know, don't you hate people like that? Doesn't that fucking drive you crazy? People, you know what I mean? People talk incessantly about themselves and never give a shit what you have to say. Do you guys know people like that?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Too many. That's why there's a certain thing called voicemail or... you know, the ignore button or
well, it's hard to do that genetic. In person, but
oh yeah,
unfortunately. But he just kept yammering on and on and on, and I said something like he was one thing he said oh, I said I'm sorry about your dog, because he had to put his dog down. I said I'm sorry about your dog, you know, he told me what happened to him and everything. I said I'm really sorry about that, and he said, oh, thanks. And I said, you know, my dog is getting older. He's 12, and he can't hear as well, and he's got arthritis. He goes, oh, really? He goes, so about this over here. I mean, and I'm like, just like talking, you know, and then that happened like three or four times in the conversation. And so, I mean, people, is that narcissism, Rose? Do you think that's narcissism? Yeah, I think so, too.
That's exactly what it is. Because it doesn't matter what you talk to them about. It's always about their mind is on themselves 24 hours a day. Like, all the time.
Exactly. Exactly. And it's like, I just, it's so fucking annoying to me. But I've known so many people like that. And so I was thinking about my past relationships, my past friendships with people. And I've known and had so many friends like that. And I'm thinking, is it something about me that, because I know I'm a really good listener. I can listen to people, and I have a genuine interest in people's problems and what they have to say. And I like people and get to know them, whatever. So I think people just take advantage of that and just railroad me, you know? So I don't know. What do you think I should do? Should I be more aggressive and just say, shut the fuck up? Or what? I mean, what am I supposed to do? Not be friends with people like that, or what?
Oh, no, be friends with them still, but, yeah, there's a point where you kind of do what they do to you.
Mm-hmm.
Just kind of, like, change the subject or turn around and don't pay attention.
I can't do that. I'm just not, it's not my nature. It's not my nature to be like that. I really care what they have to say.
But that's what it is. It's because you are a good listener. Well, and you're actually giving them that, what they want. It's that valid, you know, they have to be heard.
Well, I just don't think it'd be nice if they kind of paid, you know, the same respect to me in return. I think it's just like, fuck. I mean, this guy's not really a friend. He's a client. But still, I mean, just kind of common courtesy. No,
it's hard to talk to people like that.
It is.
No matter what subject you bring up, no matter what it is.
Yeah.
It's about them, right?
Yes. Yes.
It's irritating.
It is. And it took 3 hours just to do his penthouse that I did for him, the photographer, to finish it. And so I had to sit there and listen to him yammer on for 3 hours about himself. And every time I tried to interject anything, it was just like nothing. No response, nothing. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with you? I mean,
God. Yeah, he's not even hearing you.
I'm like, you don't have a human. It's like he's not human or something. He was raised by wolves. I don't know. It was just very strange to me. I thought it was very weird. But anyway, so that pisses me off. But tonight, I was telling Rose earlier that I went to see this movie called Gravity, which, if you guys haven't seen, is a really great movie. And you should really check it out. It's really good. It may seem boring that they're floating out there in space and that's all the movie is. It's just one actress, basically, the whole time, mostly. And but it's really an awesome, awesome show. Yes, I'm live, Ken Bogle, by the way, asking me. Yes, I'm live. But you should check it out. Sorry. Obviously. Yes. Hold on. It's over. Yeah. So anyway, Rose was telling us earlier about her obsession with couponing. And I was telling her how I dated a guy who actually used to go to the store and get $200 worth of groceries for like $1.50 or whatever. And Todd and I were both saying that we just don't have the fucking patience for that. I just couldn't do it. So are you going to start doing that again, Rose?
Not at all.
Yeah.
I'm staying home.
I know, but you'll like it because you won't have the patience for anything.
No. Well, yeah, I'll like that, but
yeah.
4 hours, really?
That's ridiculous.
Are you kidding me? I spend, like, at max 30 minutes in a damn grocery store. That's about all I can handle.
And yeah, and I'm gay, and I like to shop, but I don't like to shop that much, so I'm sorry.
Well, the time goes by because you're busy doing the math. You know, you're busy, like, it's a puzzle. It's like you're trying to...
Yeah, okay, I could be home eating Oreos, watching I Love Lucy while that's going on. I mean, no, it's just too much time.
Yeah.
Yeah, after 4 hours of walking around and pacing back and forth and doing all this calculation, I'd be like just crippled, at least halfway crippled. You're like, wow. 4 hours, really?
You know you're going to be there, too. You're going to be like,
no,
baby, give
me
that shampoo that makes my hair real soft.
Oh, you'll be there, Todd, all right, because she'll have her whip out, so I'm sure you'll be there.
Like, oh, wow.
She's cracking that whip.
Oh, not the whip, please.
Be like, get me that good lotion. give me that one.
Oh, my gosh. Like, yeah, don't forget the condoms, baby. We're going to need those, too.
Oh, my God. I won't buy those.
Oh, wait. Who's David? David Banks is calling in. David. Oh, sorry. I say your last name there, David. David, can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you guys.
Hold on. Let me add you to the call, because I think I actually... How the fuck do I add you? Hold on a second. This is the one.
What
okay. You're there, Rose, and you're there, Todd, right?
Want me to add you to my call?
How do I add David to the call? David, hold on, David, are you there? Oh, wait, shit. It says he's on hold. Hold on. David, are you there? David, you there? David.
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, I'm going to add you to this other call. Let's see how I do it here. Add people. Oh, fuck, this is impossible. Don't go away. So, wait, I'm trying to add him now. David Banks. Oh, sorry, I said your name again. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, David. Hold on.
Yes, I'm here. I'm okay. here as well.
Now, David, are you there now? Fuck. David. Okay.
It's not calling.
I'm going to hang up and call you, Dave, and add you to the call, okay?
Okay.
Okay, I'm gonna call you right back. Okay. All right. Yeah. Are y'all there? Okay, I'm going to call him now. I'm going to add him to the call. I found out how to do it here. Add people. This is the only drawback by this. Okay, I'm calling him now. It says it's calling him. How do I... This is no answer. Answer the phone, David.
Answer it. Do we have to add him?
I'm trying to add him to our call, and it says no answer. Oh my gosh, this is annoying. David, call back. Okay, there he is. Oh, there he is. David's there. Yay, David, you there?
Yes, I am.
David, Desert, and Trey. Sorry, not Trey. Todd are there.
Todd?
I'm sorry, I'm giving everybody's names away today. Anyway, hey, David, what's going on?
Nothing. Let's just listen to you guys cut up.
Hey, could you hear all of us clearly on my show, or was it really bad?
It was really good, actually.
Oh, you could hear all our voices?
Yep, everybody.
Oh, right.
Oh, it was clear?
To me, it was.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay, well, thank good. You.
It sounded really clear through my headphones and, you know, my headset and all that good stuff. So
I was listening. Maybe you rose when I heard it. It was because I was on the air with you and it sounded different to me or something. I hope.
Well, maybe this will work then. At least we can kind of come back.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, calls are important. So, David, what do you think about what we've been talking about so far tonight?
You talked about gravity, and then you talked about... What were you talking about earlier?
Couponing? Or talking about narcissistic people?
Actually, I think I'm that way, and I just kind of dominate conversations, and I try to... And I'm a good listener as well, but I dominate conversations because I think I have interesting stuff to share, and then I think everybody around me is stupid. but I don't mean to do it, and then I consciously say, okay, David, stop talking. But they have nothing to say, so if you're not going to talk, then I'm going to carry
the conversation. I've never had that. I don't think that's how you are. I mean, at least with me, I've never had that impression of you. It's not that when I talk to you, whether it's via texting online, text messages, or verbally, it's back and forth. It's a conversation where you converse.
See, that's the difference.
Yeah, this guy was like, you know how to converse. Yeah, so this guy was all one way, though. He was just all about himself, blah, 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 blah. And when I would try to give him something about myself to try to relate to him, he'd be, oh, that's nice, blah, blah, blah. You don't do that.
But you can't do that to me because I'm like, okay, I'm going to need you to stop that. You know, just check him. Then that'll stop.
He's a client. Like that. I couldn't do that. I mean, I could, but
whatever.
The truth is, the project was over, so I guess I probably could have, but I didn't want to be rude.
I would have shut it down. Trust.
I mean, I just really wanted to tell him to shut the fuck up. I'm like, what is wrong with you? I mean, I'm like trying to relate to you as a human being, and you sit there just like yammering on, like, fuck, shut the fuck up. But anyway. I mean, what are you gonna do? Go ahead.
My ex best friend is like that, and I struggle. But you know, we have a 15-year relationship, friendship, in which we're not friends anymore because of this. This is one of the particular reasons. And he would actually say, "Okay, back to me." And he meant it. I'm like, dude, come on now, don't do that. And I tolerate it because, you know, 15 years being best friends and. I know how he is. And I was like, that aggravates me. So I just had enough. I'm like, I'm done with you. I can't do this anymore.
Well, you know, a good conversation is like a tennis match, they say. And I agree with that. It's about, I'm serving to you. I'm giving you something. You're giving me something back. You know what I mean? It's back and forth. It's not just a soliloquy or a monologue. So That's all I mean. Just show somebody some respect.